You'll see Trevor Baptiste. He's the reigning MVP. He's the best faceoff man on the planet. And it's going to be a big challenge for the Woods and T.D. Yerlin, who's not no slouch himself, but that's going to be a big battle to watch.
Yeah, one versus two in the PLL in terms of faceoff percentage. Baptiste has been spectacular statistically, even better than a year ago, if you can imagine that. But what's interesting is the early offense. At times, the Atlas have struggled in that department and weren't able to really capitalize throughout the course of the regular season on all of those Baptiste wins.
There you see Baptiste. Played his college lacrosse at Denver. Yerlin also played some of his college lacrosse at Denver as well as Albany.
Yeah, these are the two best statistically in the PLL. Both played for Team USA as well. So you can argue maybe the best two faceoff guys in the world now that Joe Nardella is hurt as well.
Possession though goes to the Atlas. That was ruled a pass, so it'll be a turnover. Picked up by Jack Kelly in goal for the Redwoods in green. And I mentioned the Woods have been streaky. They won their...
The emergence of Cole Kearse, because in the beginning of the season, he was kind of in and out of the lineup. They were figuring out, yeah, what type of player is he? He has delivered a punch down the stretch for this team.
Baptiste can shoot. Number nine in white. He is not afraid to let it fly after winning a faceoff. This is wide. It stays with that.
And as a pro, statistically, career high in goals with 14. And it seems like they both benefited from a fresh start here.
I agree with you. I think they both needed it. Miles was even out of the lineup for a couple of games for Redwoods, and I think it just makes sense. Fresh start oftentimes in this league makes sense. The difference in skill, Kark, between every single extra work, and I remember watching it, Kark, and thinking, these are the best players in the world, and they still need and want and use that extra work after practice, one-on-one stuff.
Yeah, you want to visualize, and you look at a guy like Jules, he's a midfielder, and he's played defense sleeping. A defense that has had many of problems this season. They've given up the most goals in all of the PLL. And now they're dealing with an inside guy who can dunk it in Westberg.
Well, Kark, I was talking to Seth Tierney on the side about that play. He reminds me of a net front presence guy in hockey. He just takes a beating.
He does. And he gets the job done, as does Nekhai Montgomery. This is a guy who had all kinds of woes on the offensive end, Clark. Maybe trying to find the right role for him in this offense, like you talked about with the midfielders. Last couple of weeks, no problem.
Look, confidence is a powerful thing, as I mentioned before. Nekhai hadn't scored a goal prior to last week in Seattle. He had a two-pointer and a regular goal, and this one is beautiful. He flashes with that speed. And look at the placement on this shot. I mean, that is flat out straight line speed by Nekhai Montgomery. But I will say this, even when he was struggling to find at the back of the net, his presence was felt, whether it's feeding the ball, playing as a two-way midfielder. If they get an offensive punch coming out of the box with Nekhai, and Cole Kearse continues to emerge, and Charlie Bertrand gets healthy, now this midfield has some momentum.
A loose ball hold against Baptiste, and Erland's getting the better of Baptiste here early.
I love it out here, Connor, and it's gorgeous with the mountains in the backdrop. But the game of lacrosse is exploding out here. Guys like Will Manny, who live here, who play for the Whipsnakes, and Marcus Holman spent a bunch of years out here. Bubba Fairman is from Utah.
Adam
plays
Gittleman.
The Cannons. Yep. Adam Gittleman lives out here. Another Cannons player.
I mean, I could see why. Jump shot. Concannon is there to make the save. We'll get it inside the crease, so we'll go the other way.
But you have these.
Circled that guy and knew they were going to have to deal with him.
A hard checker, a guy who could shoot from deep. And when you watch him, don't be surprised if Nat St. Laurent puts him on a wing on faceoffs. He's unbelievable on ground balls as well.
That Baptiste win breaks a string of three straight wins by T.D. Yerlin at the faceoff strike.
RK3,
we get a good
RK3.
Battle there.
Aggressive T, aggressive TD.
You know, you and I thought it was a slam dunk for the Atlas to get in at the last spot. If the Atlas get absolutely blowtorched in the chrome win by a bunch against the chaos.
Right.
we've been stopping transition. Offensive middies have been coming back, playing D, and we've been doing a really good job on that.
Thank you, Ed.
Yeah, thank you, Eddie. Eddie Glazer.
Me?
California kid. Went to Notre Dame. One of those guys, too, is Cole Kirsch. This Redwoods team has a lot of two-way middies, guys that are going to stay on the field on both ends. Nakai certainly was one of them. Cole Kirsch is another one. And that pays dividends.
Yeah, and Eddie was talking about their ability. Way that I could explain the attack position and the way that you're kind of pigeonholed into a spot. If you were to watch or look at a shot chart of most players, they'd be concentrated in one area. Like Connor Fields, elite, maybe the best attacker playing right now in the PLL. The majority of his spots where he scores from on a shot chart would be in that same lefty high wing. Into thinking that he's going to go, and then he backsteps and hits that pass. That is a smart lacrosse player with anticipation, knowing that when he gets a short stick, the Redwoods want to support the matchup, slide early, he becomes the passer.
Well, Brian Costabile really intelligently just told me, T draws a lot of attention, so he just snuck up on the backside. Didn't have to do a whole lot of thinking on that one. Easy play for him. T draws the attention, and he scores.
Redwoods pick up possession off that draw from Erland. Nat St. Laurent calls a timeout, wants to talk things over. His team up 8-2 here in the second.
Like, if I'm Danny Logan, I'm mad. That's like a lockdown corner getting safety help when you don't need it. Like, let me do my thing.
Mm-hmm. Trevor wins it. Tells players like Costabile to go to the net, which he does here. Can't get a shot off, though, as he gets knocked off his feet. Kelly comes out to pick it up. Final minute of the first half, dominated by the Redwoods. Don't forget, a win by the Redwoods secures them the... I wouldn't want to get in the way of that. Timing couldn't have been better. 9-3 in the waning seconds of this first half. Atlas absolutely had to have it. They got one back. And maybe they can carry a little momentum into the locker room with the half down just 6. Number 4 spot as far as the playoffs go. Obviously, if the Atlas can come back and get a win, they would be in the 7th seed. Even with a loss, as long as they don't get royally blown out like it looked. That 7th and final playoff seed, but even a loss that's relatively close in terms of final score will get him in. Baptiste and Erland continue to battle. 7-6. Erland with the advantage, but it's razor thin. Got dumped by Chris Merle right at the end. Paid for it.
Yeah, Kark, Chris, when you talk about taking a hit to make a play, look no further than right there, Eric Law. That can give your team a lot of momentum. Only time will tell, but a big boost for this Atlas group that needs it.
The night, baby.
Right. So brutal. I also like the being very, cordial with the officials. I mean, he learned from the best, Coach Corrigan at Notre Dame.
Pants.
How to work the official
of angle. It's one of the most efficient shots, not only because of your angle increasing, but because of the deception you put on a goalie.
And Miles Jones now involved in the last 3 Atlas goals, scoring right before the end of the first half and picking up 2 quick assists here in the second half.
Well, Jones's mindset right now is just let it hang loose. He usually puts a lot of pressure on himself, but not with this group. And what he said in that timeout right there during the huddle was, we have to dodge hard, and that's exactly what he did to open up that opportunity for Dixon to score that goal.
And Miles is playing with a chip.
30-second technical. Push.
Hey, Fred.
I mean, Cotter, you're across his face and increases his angle by about 3 feet, and that's all he needed.
Teat with his third assist on that dish, too. It's a three-goal game. We'll get another push here. This time it's going to go against the Wood. No, against the Atlas, rather. Woods ball.
There's nothing in terms of his line and his attack mode going towards the cage that throws him off there, Cotter.
He just put his head down and was not going to be denied.
Brett Makar always makes you feel him. And Cole Kirst going after Danny Logan, going after Brett Makar. This guy has like the house money mentality right now. Two. It's not like he's just looking to go to the rack. Spot feeds Westberg.
Bergie with another hat trick as well. I think Westberg is going to celebrate by going up into the mountains. The rest of the